Hey guys, I'm Tara with Tara Simon Studios, and today I'm going to be reacting to the one, the only Miss Mariah Carey. She is performing live at the Grammys, We Belong Together. Here we go. Stop right there for a second. That stressed me out. This is an incredibly hard song to sing, and this is, to me, when Mariah started to decline a little bit from her prime. I still hear the amazingness and the power, the height, the classic kind of double-tony top, that cry that she has that's so specifically Mariah that you hear in 3 seconds, you know, oh, that's Mariah Carey, right? It's iconic, it's legendary. I hear also stress in her voice, though, that she's, I feel like she's worried that it's not going to come out. I feel that as a listener, and maybe it's just me as a coach, like, listening to little nuancey things, but I can tell that she's really definitely using her whole body to get sound out, which is good and needed, especially for the level of difficulty in the song. But there are parts even in the lower end towards the beginning that weren't really quite there. And I don't know if it's because she was thinking of the next part, like the high part, or if it was just that's harder for her actually than the top end. I'm not sure, because it seems like when she got up there, it was almost like, okay, now I'm home a little bit. It's hard, but I'm home. I know this. And Mariah is usually always up in the rafters, so it's exhilarating to hear, but I don't know. I kind of felt like she was a little concerned about if it was gonna happen for her. And that long hold at the end especially felt stressful to me. She held on to it, but it was like, Are you gonna fall off? And the mic was really far back, which is an indication for me, like a lot of singers, including myself, hey, let's be honest, when you're not sure how something's gonna go, it's always best to pull back real quick, especially in the start of it, and then come back into it, than just flat out crack or lose yourself in the biggest part of the amplification of the head of the mic, right? It's better just wow real quick and then bring it back when you know it's fine. And I felt like this being held out so far was an indication not of panning the mic because of her loudness, but going far away because of maybe an insecurity of if it's gonna continue to hold or not. Sorry, it's just what I'm seeing. Vocal break here, which is nice for her.
Weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. Trust me.
Somehow I know that there's a place up above with all my hurt and struggling.
Love that.
Of all the trust of tears and suffering, because I feel the
runs aren't clear. They're not crisp. her, like what she's comfortable with.
Said he'll never forsake you, nor leave you alone. Trust him.
Pretty. And there's that perfect, airy, angelic tone that we get. Perfect placement right there. Yes. Yes. I think what I said before is true. I think that higher end is really her home. That's where she's secure. Great placement, Baron. Great placement. Yes. Yes. Woo! Yes. That was that. Yeah. Yeah. Yes, Mariah. That was great. Okay, okay. I can get behind that second half. So her fly like a bird part, I really feel like something special happened when the choir started backing her up. Like, she wasn't on... It's not like she's scared of being on stage alone, but for some reason I felt like in the first song, We Belong Together, it was like she was just warming up or something. It was just her. There was some apprehension in her voice. There was tension. I saw it on her face. I felt it in her tone. But then when that choir came in and she sang Fly Like a Bird, it was like, that's the Mariah that I know. That's the one from the album that I grew up listening to and, you know, warming up to in the tub when I was little, going and singing 6 a.m. different places. Like, that's the chick that I tried to sing like when I was younger. And the whistle tones were amazing. When she got up into her upper register chest voice, it was ringing true and locking into place exactly like you want it to, exactly like I'm sure she was expecting it to. And her control, even in the lower portions of this song and Fly Like a Bird, were much more secure, much more in the pocket. She only had, I think, one run misstep at the very beginning of it. I personally thought that Fly Like a Bird was way better than the We Belong Together. There were great parts in We Belong Together, but as a whole, cohesively, I think Fly Like a Bird was definitely Fly Like a Bird for the Wind. That was the better of the two, in my opinion. Mariah is a legend. She is amazing. I love her. And I really appreciate you guys asking me to react to her. If you're looking to get reacted to yourself, check out instareactions.com. It's something very new that we rolled out recently. And there's also an 8-week course I developed called Sing Smarter, Not Harder. If you're, it doesn't matter where you are in the world, if you're a closet singer, if you're a secret singer, if you're a scaredy cat singer, and you don't even know if you should be singing, check out InstaReactions or the 8-week course. They're great ways to kind of dip your toe in the water, dive in anonymously. You know, you don't really have to tell anyone you're even doing the course. It can be in your own time. Doesn't matter what time zone you're in. It's drip fed. The content's yours for life once you get it. And bonus, you get 50% off of any private lessons while you're in the course. So make sure that you check those two things out and like us on Instagram as well and subscribe to the channel and click that notifications button while you're at it. Thanks so much, guys. I'll see you in the next one.